What's up, everybody? My name is Kazu, and I'm your host slash producer of the Urban Influencer Radio. I hope you all are doing well. If you're listening right now, make sure to subscribe and like the Urban Influencer's social media page. Links are down below. This is the second show of 2018, and we should get started with an interview with Tony Neal, the CEO of Core DJs. Let's get it.
All right, this is the Urban Influencer Radio. I'm your host, Kazu, and we're with Tony Neal of Core DJ. How are you doing?
I'm good. How you doing?
Pretty good, pretty good. You're currently in Miami right now, right?
Oh, yeah, yep.
How are things over there?
It's good, man. I can't complain. I'm just chilling. Just working and chilling.
Yeah, that's what's up. That's what's up. Yeah. So, just to kind of want to know, like, a little bit of about your background, when did you first start DJing?
Oh, start DJing? Man, probably seriously? I mean, I messed around with it when I was younger, but seriously, probably 91.
Oh, 91.
92.
Okay, so over 20 years then, huh? Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah, did you grow up in, like, a creative household? Like, did your mom or dad, like, play music growing up?
Nah, my mother just sung in the choir. I played the piano a little bit in church and stuff like that, younger, but, you know, as I got older, I was doing other things outside of music. So, you know, I just kind of came back to music, you know what I'm saying? I just kind of came back to it, you know?
Yeah,
so,
yeah.
For me, my family, a lot of my family, not immediate family, but a lot of distant family and cousins and uncles and stuff like that were on radio already, but I never asked them for no, just get on the radio and no shit like that when I was growing up. I just kind of got it, fell into it myself.
Right. Okay. Yeah, that's really interesting. Now, for like, you know, for those like who doesn't know what a core DJ is, would you be able to like tell us like a little bit about that?
I mean, just in a nutshell, it's not your typical crew. It's a big organization of with everybody. You got publicists in it, you got DJs in it, you got models, you got, you know, it's like a one stop shop. It's like a big ass Costco of the DJ crews. You know what I'm saying? Like,
yeah.
You know, it's over 500 some DJs across the country worldwide, and it's just you know. It's just something that we use as a networking tool to, you know, in-house, you know, one-stop shop for anything that we need, you know what I'm saying? So it's just, I started it, copyrighted and all in 2004, but I really started it in 2005, you know what I'm saying?
Oh, okay. Gotcha. And the organization itself is responsible for, like, breaking artists, correct?
Oh, yeah, absolutely, yeah.
Okay, gotcha. No, I think that's really, really interesting. And, you know, especially, like, ever since you started DJing in 91, I'm pretty sure you saw, like, a lot of change, like, within the music industry. And kind of wondering, like, do you feel like, do DJs have autonomy to break new artists in this digital age?
Oh, yeah, absolutely. And it's more so now, especially the... Not the young artists, you know, but, you know, because the young artists typically start because they were brought up in the digital age and the millennial art. These artists were brought up with phones damn near in their hand at birth.
Yeah.
You know, they don't really go out and seek DJs to, and they really don't have relationships with DJs. So they don't really go out and seek for DJs to play their music until they start falling off.
Right.
So what it is, you know, at some point, they have to see a DJ, you know, no matter if they started in the digital age and then they start, you know, and with that being said, when you have a digital career, it's faster. Your career is over faster, too.
Right.
You know, because it's always somebody coming behind you with the same phone and always somebody behind the same laptop and the same computer, the same iPad, same iPhone coming right behind you. Immediately, almost immediately, you know, when it wasn't like that before, you know. So, and your lifespan of being an artist or a rapper was 7 to 10 years. Now it's 1 to 3 years.
Yeah, I get you. Do you feel like streaming services also changing the way records are breaking too?
Yeah. Of course, it's the same thing. Like I'm saying, like the phones, you know. But like I said, you know, now it's the opposite. The younger artists seek out the DJs when they're falling off.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But the older artists, not digitally, most of them are not digitally inclined unless they're a big superstar artist. And then somebody's handling their digital.
Right.
Because they just don't do it. You know, they just don't really, you know, do it.
Right. Okay. Gotcha.
So, Even with that platform, somebody else is handling their digital platform because it's just something that they don't do.
Yeah, I guess
so. You know, the streaming thing did change the game, but it's always, the DJ has always remained the same, man. It's always the same thing, you know? You know, it's just the DJs got to keep up. DJs, I blame DJs for not keeping up with the times.
Right.
You know, so that, you know, that's it.
Yeah, especially like, no, that's really interesting how you're talking about how, like, if the artist falls off, then, like, they come to you for, like, to seek, like, help and such. So, like, it's really
Yeah,
I didn't know that. That's the way it worked. But so, like, currently, like, you're DJing at, like, at a hip hop station and pop station in Miami, like at like a radio station over there.
Well, my home station's 99 Jams and Hot 105 in Miami, but I'm on 6 stations in South Florida. See, I do my own syndication.
Oh wow, you're extremely busy then, huh?
Yeah, I'm on 45 stations.
Damn, that's crazy. Yeah.
So you know, I just kind of built my relationship. I just kind of started submitting my own mixes and.
I feel like definitely like the pros of like being a DJ is like you're able to build like a connection with like artists and like different like radio stations, but like what do you think is like the downside of being a DJ? Like, is there anything like that in your opinion?
I think the downside of being a DJ is not keeping up with the time. You're getting older and getting disgruntled, you know. A lot of DJs get old and they get disgruntled.
Really?
Get mad, you know.
Yeah, that's it.
I don't really see it. If you keep up and do everything you're supposed to do and roll with the punches, I don't really see a downside to being a DJ.
Right, yeah, that's true.
Stay healthy. Another downside of being a DJ is they DJs don't stay healthy. They particularly, you know, they eat bad, sleep bad, drink bad, you know, most of the time.
Right.
Know? And from long nights, you know, shit like that. But other than that,
I get you. What do you, in your opinion, how do you feel about the state of hip hop right now, especially because you say like you've been seriously DJing from like 91, so you witnessed like the golden age kind of transitioning to this like more of like a SoundCloud age. So like I just wanted to kind of hear your thoughts.
I know it's the same thing. I don't know. I just look at it the same way when they used to put out cassette singles. You know,
right.
I just look at it the same way. It's just digital. Everything is digital. We went back to single 45s. SoundCloud singles, you know, going back to singles, except the streaming, you just get your music out a lot faster, you know?
I think
that even DJs need to have their own SoundCloud, their own Spotify pages, their own artist pages, because at the end of the day, the DJ is an artist too.
Right.
So, you know, I got my own, you know, I think everybody should have their own thing, their own platform. I think they should learn and don't fight the Joneses and learn how to, you know, do this digital thing.
Yeah, that's true. Yeah, in your opinion, like, where do you think is, like, the best place to, like, find new music? I know there's, like, a lot of, like, different, like, outlets out there, but, like, where do you usually, like, look at?
I don't know. I get a lot of it coming to me. So, for me, I don't know. That's a good question, man, because I get a lot of it coming to me. So, I don't really have anyone in particular that I go to, maybe a new music server, maybe. I don't really have anybody that I really go just searching for music for.
Right,
if I need something, I hit up a label rep and ask for it, you know.
Yeah, that's true, because you want...
Yeah.
Especially with, like, those artists, like, falling off, and plus, like, if people, like, want their record to break, it's like, you're, like, the person to go to, so, you know, especially...
Yeah, you know, I got my own digital platforms, and I do my website and different stuff like that, so, you know, if I need something, I just ask, you know. I really just call, text somebody, email them, and ask for it. But other than that, you know, it's not too much stuff. I can't keep up with all the stuff that's coming out of this, you know. Some of this stuff that's coming out, I'll never play again. It'll never get played again, you know. So for me, I just, unless it's sampled on something later on in life, but.
Yeah.
So for me, it's not urgent. It's not an urgent record that I need to find. You know, I don't really go search for no records like that unless it's something I asked for. And if it's something that's that major, I get it already. You know what I'm saying?
Right, of course. Yeah, because it's going to be something that's going to be played eventually. So, like, yeah.
Exactly.
I getcha. Well, no, that's really interesting, man. Do you ever get, like, kind of like these fanatic musicians, like, who would, like, go up, like, directly run up to your station with, like, a CD in his hand and be like, yo, man, play my record.
Yeah, you know what? I've seen a lot of times where artists was outside the station, a whole lot of times, man.
Right.
And I'd break it down and tell them that's not the way it goes.
Mm-hmm.
You know?
Yeah, you know, that's like the type of shit that you see in, like, movies. So, like, you know, I was kind of wondering, especially, like...
Yeah, not now. That's not the way it goes now.
Yeah.
No, it's a great gesture, but that's really not how it goes now. You know?
That's true.
No,
yeah,
man.
Definitely. Well, I just want to say, I think I pretty much, like, asked everything I wanted to ask, like, you know, for, you know, Tony right here. But I just want to say thank you for joining us on the Urban Influencer for this, like, quick interview. And hopefully, like, everything goes well with what you're currently doing.
Oh, man, I appreciate it. Thank you for the call.
Yeah, man, no problem. And hopefully we'll talk to you again soon.
Cool.
All right, later. Thank you.
That was Tony Neal. Next up is an artist that's been gaining a lot of buzz. He goes by Just Chase, and this track is called Ego.
Hey. Every night sipping on potion, trying to drink away some emotions, trying to get out of hypnosis, babe. Oh yeah. And all the texts I'm texting you is still getting no replies. Damn. Three dots, no response. I said, if you could just do one thing for me, cause attitude on grubby, bro, getting kind of bubbly. You acting like you're so far away from here. You acting like you didn't lie. That smile, oh yeah. All you gotta do is love me somehow. And I really wanna say, won't you let down your, baby, let down your ego. Is there any way around your ego?
Yeah, just for a minute, yeah,
baby, let down your ego. Kiss it down for a minute, say. Cause you know I've been around for no more. Just jump for a minute, say. Kiss it down for a minute, say. Cause you know I'm not hearing them stories no more, no. You spend the whole summer on the other side. Now tell me, was it really worth it? Got you running back on purpose, nah. See, me and you used to disagree on another thing that we used to do last year, so now I pray every day that we re-improve on a lot of things this year, so and you're all grumpy, bro, getting kind of bobby in here. You acting like you're so far away from here. Quit acting like you didn't lost that smile.
Was Just Chase with the song Ego. Let's move on to our last interview of the day with Storm Diesel on the Urban Influencer Radio.
All right, this is the Urban Influencer Radio. I'm your host / producer Kazu, and we have Storm Diesel on the line. How's it going, man?
Good. What's going on, man? What are you up to?
Not much, man. You know, just pretty much producing podcasts and interviewing artists and just doing all the work. and yeah, you know, I love doing this, so I'm just having fun with it. You know, I see that you're enjoying music too. But how's everything with you going on?
Going good, man. Yeah, that's it. Just music, you know, all day. You know, working on a brand new album actually right now, and I think I'm gonna have it ready actually probably close to Christmas time. You know, 2018. It's called Singularity.
Singularity. Oh, that's a pretty cool name. Yeah, that's really awesome. But by the way, where are you from?
Kansas City, Missouri.
Kansas City, Missouri. Oh, okay, yeah, my dad is from Missouri, surprisingly, yeah.
Yeah. Nice. Yeah, we're under a little ice storm going on right now, actually.
Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah, well, a lot of roads are shut down.
I see, man. Yeah, I wanted to get to know a little bit about your background in music, but did you grow up in, like, a creative household? Like, did your mom or dad play instruments or sing at all?
Well, you know, it's kind of a weird thing. Like, my dad was actually a kind of just like a homegrown kind of bongo aficionado, and I didn't know him real well because he kind of like passed away when I was about 6 years old. But from what I understand,
yeah,
he used to go around town in Kansas City, like downtown Kansas City, and
yeah.
sit in on a lot of jam sessions, and
yeah.
So. Although he wasn't really like a singer or nothing like that, he played the bongos, and also he was a good songwriter. So he used to write songs back in the day for B.J. Thomas, I guess, from what I understand.
Oh, I see.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's
crazy.
That's really interesting.
Right.
Yeah, no, that's really really cool. How did you first get into singing?
Well, actually, I actually started out dancing. So, like, you know, we were doing, like, a lot of break dance and, you know, the old flatten out the cardboard box.
Yeah.
<know. laughs> So we started that, but that was right about the time, though, that, like, groups like Boys to Men, you guys might remember, like, Shy,
yeah.
Silk,
yeah.
You know, a lot of that stuff. So it was kind of like, okay, so the break dancing's cool, but... The doo-wop thing was in, so me and a lot of the guys thought we'd try to transition.
Right.
And then we just kind of, and it was kind of, one, not that any of us were fantastic singers, but we could all keep our notes. So we was like, oh my God, we can actually do harmonies and stuff. So I actually formed a boy band back in the day.
Right.
called Part Four. And we had a little, some videos.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, some little singles and stuff out here, you know, in Kansas City and stuff like that. But eventually the group, you know, everybody split up, you know, life gets a hold of everybody. So that's really how I ended up becoming a solo artist, and I've just been doing that ever since.
Okay. So you developed yourself through being in a group, and then everybody kind of went their own separate ways. But is everybody else doing solo projects too, or like?
Well, I think one or two of them is. I know at one point, one half of our group actually was a group, a boy band called Youngstown, and they were signed to Hollywood Records for a while.
Right.
And, you know, they did some soundtrack stuff for, like, the Inspector Gadget movie, things like that. But I think since then, you know, everyone's kind of, I think there's, like, two of them that might be doing some solo stuff, just on the down low, you know?
Yeah. I see. All
right.
Okay, that's cool. Well, you know, let's discuss a little bit more about your music. Your single Right Now that we're going to be playing on the podcast in a little bit. Would you like to talk a little bit about that song?
Yeah, you know, it was just, that was one of them songs where I was just kind of going through kind of a relationship situation where, you know, one day it was this and then the next day it was that, and it was kind of like, you know, what's that old saying? You either do something or get off the pot.
Right, yeah.
That's kind of what the song is saying in a nice, elegant, melodic way. So it's basically just telling the person that you're with or whatever, you know, just tell me right now, what are we doing? Like, I need to know the answer now, because if not, I'm going to go ahead and go this way. So that was
right.
The inspiration for that.
Okay, gotcha. Are a lot of your songs like inspired by like the relationships that you've had in the past, or like is it kind of motivated through like heartbreak and stuff? Or
well, I would honestly, I'd say about 50% of it is.
Okay.
I mean, a lot of, you know, when it comes to like maybe like some of the up-tempo dance type songs, you know, obviously those are just songs that are just, you know, everybody's at the club, you know, just one of those songs, you know, but the other 50% is I do take pieces of stuff, you know, that happened to me or I kind of went through. And the crazy thing is it doesn't always have to be recent stuff. Like,
yeah,
I might go back to when I was 17 and remember that girl that broke my heart and decide to write a song about that, you know? So it's not always like recent events, but I do take pieces of experiences.
That's true, yeah. It's
right.
Taking pieces of your life and turning it into art, you know, it's a beautiful thing, right? You know.
Right, exactly.
No, that's awesome, dude. I was kind of wondering, like, you know, what were some of the artists that you grew up listening to, or like, were there like anybody specific where you felt like that inspired you to becoming a singer?
Yes. That right away I could tell you, but before I tell you, I have to make this disclaimer that I'm really disappointed of what's happened to him over the years.
Okay.
But immediately I would say R. Kelly. That was my, oh yeah, like I bought everything R. Kelly, listened to all his records, I just thought he was one of the, and I still do think he's one of the greatest songwriters in R&B pop ever.
Yeah.
So I would say heavily influenced by R. Kelly. But, of course, you know, I was also influenced by the melodies of, like, Smokey Robinson, which I had the opportunity of him mentoring me for a little bit when I was signed to a label out in L.A. at that time.
Okay.
All right.
I see. That's really cool how, like, how you were like under that label and stuff. But are you also particularly into what's it called? Because since you mentioned like, you know, R. Kelly and Smokey Robinson, it's like kind of like more in like kind of like an older reign of like R&B. But how do you feel about like modern R&B now? Like if you look at Bryson Tiller or like The Weeknd, like do you feel like do you think they still have like the same spirit as like, you know, kind of like the R. Kelly and Smokey Robinson does?
I do. I mean, there's no doubt. I will say this. I'm kind of partial to the 90s, you know, kind of style of R&B, like when Jodeci and all that stuff was happening. And you know, for me, I'm kind of like, that was it for me. But I will say a lot of the newer R&B artists today, man, are really, really killing it. You know, whether they're doing doo-wop or whether they've got three other guys singing harmonies, I mean, they're still coming with like really good songs. The melodies are hot, so
yeah,
I mean, you know, I'm loving the new R&B stuff, no doubt about it.
Yeah, that's cool. Now I kind of want to get to know a bit more about, like, you know, kind of like the future of like Storm Diesel and like, you know, what you're planning on doing. But you were telling me that you have this like new album Singularity coming out sometimes in Christmas this year. But are you planning on like playing any shows in between recordings, or like you know, what's your
Definitely. I mean, I'll definitely be doing you know, some performances and some shows around the Kansas City area. But what I really am looking to do is I really need to get on like a hot tour that's moving around the country.
Right.
That's what I really need to do. But see, I'm also, you know, I'm trying to be like this, a one man show, and, it's just not, going as well as planned, but what I really need is a manager. So I'm kind of in the process of trying to find a good manager as well. And I think I just really need to like I said, get on a hot tour and, just get it moving. Although I love Kansas City,
yeah,
you know, there are some folks out there in other states who do enjoy my music and things like that. So I just feel like I need to kind of get out and start moving around to some of those folks too, and keep this little buzz going. You know, I call them, you know, it's funny, you know, everyone has their little tagline for what they call their fans or whatever. So these guys have all come up with this name. You know, these are my stormtroopers, you know what I mean? So I feel like I need to
Yeah.
I need to get out there and you know, perform for them. So those are some of my goals I'm looking for as well.
The Stormtroopers, so I like that, man.
So, yeah. So I would say, hey, if good managers out there, if you're listening to me, get a hold of Kazoo or get a hold of me, and, yeah, let's do this.
No, definitely, dude. All right, well, yeah, I know that's going to, like, wrap up our interview, but right after this, so we're going to be playing Right Now by Storm Diesel, and I just want to say, dude, thank you so much for being on the program, and I had a lot of fun talking with you, man.
Yeah, thank you, man. Thanks for having me on. I appreciate it. And give me a holler anytime.
Yeah, please do. You know, come by LA and play us a show.
I'll probably be out there soon, and you got it.
Will do, man. All right, peace. Thank you.
All right, thank you, brother. All right, bye-bye.
And I got that message you sent. Every single word, girl, it cut like a knife. Another hug you meant. This ain't exactly how I wanna live my life. Where did we go wrong? When did our love go down, down, down? Now I'll keep it 100 by the words to this song. Oh, no. Baby, you need to tell me right now what you wanna do. Baby, tell me right now. Girl, I'm asking you. Girl, should we pursue? Tell me all the way through, baby, tell me right now. Baby, you need to tell me right now what you wanna do, baby, tell me right now. Girl, I'm asking you, girl, should we pursue? Tell me all the way through, baby, tell me right now. Girl, we've been going through the same things.
Steady fussing like you're doing right now.
Girl, I thought things would change.
He's calling us out of our names.
Where did our love go wrong? When did our love go down, down, down? Girl, I'ma keep it 100, these words to this song.
Baby, you need to tell me right now,
hey,
what you wanna do. Baby, tell me right now. Girl,
girl,
I'm asking you. Should we pursue? Tell me all the way through, baby, tell me right now. Baby, you need to tell me right now what you wanna do. Baby, tell me right now. Girl, I'm asking you. Girl, should we pursue? Tell me all the way through, baby, tell me right now.
That was Right Now by Storm Diesel. I hope y'all enjoyed the show. Don't forget to follow us on our social media. My name is Kazu, and I'll see you again on the Urban Influencer Radio. Peace.